Have you ever thought about investing? Also, what gives the best return on your money and time? What if I told you, and believe me, most successful people will tell you the same, that you are the most important place you can put your time and money. Yet most people neglect this piece of advice in life. As quoted by the most famous investor of all time, Warren Buffett, the best investment you can make is in yourself. But why, you may ask? The best investment is the one that adds value. Now, if you add more value than anybody else does and you work harder on yourself every day, you'll become more intelligent and more skilled, which together mean more value. If you add more value to other people, they will pay for it. Before we get into the how to accomplish this part of the video, make sure to subscribe and push the notification bell, so you don't miss out on anything important. What you have to acknowledge is that by improving your talents, skills and abilities, you're investing in something that you'll always have. Moreover, nobody can tax it or take it away from you. As we've seen throughout the years, markets can crash, stocks and bonds can be lost, but your knowledge, if used wisely, can give you significant returns. Self-investment is always worth it. Of course, experts will often talk about investing in index funds, ETFs, 401ks, IRAs and real estate. But the investment that can deliver greater results is you. Let's see how to invest in yourself. First of all, learn to manage your time. You can bet your money on it. That time is the most valuable thing you have, so managing it effectively is the most efficient way to invest in yourself. So, it might be very useful to write down everything you do throughout the day, then review it before going to bed. Then, create a schedule around the most important things to do the next day. That also means, learning to set goals. You should set personal and business goals for yourself. If you're not doing this, it's like running in the dark forest without a flashlight. If you don't know where you're going, you are wasting precious time. Be sure to also set some time frames in which to meet them. Your goals should be the so-called SMART goals: specific, measurable, attainable, relevant, and timely. Decide where you want to be in the future. Then, work backwards from there and determine the little goals that will work together to get you there. Now, the next one might sound a bit strange, but you should choose your friends wisely. That, in this case, means that whatever your goal in life is, whether it is to get rich, be happy, powerful or more productive, find people who share that passion and invest in spending time with them. This might further motivate you on your track towards your goals. One of the best investments that you can do is to learn. Take a course or just simply learn a new skill. Courses can teach you a brand new skill, help you get promoted in your current career or qualify and pursue another career path. You should always follow in the footsteps of successful people and always be learning. Check out Skillshare, for example, an online platform with thousands of free high-quality courses. You could also browse YouTube, a great learning platform. Developing and improving skills doesn't always mean investing in higher education, though that's surely a good option. Extra classes, advanced degrees, relevant certifications are all good investments. You could also enroll in workshops, attend conferences or participate in webinars. Online learning has never been easier. YouTube, for example, as I said earlier, can be your best class ever, with great teachers. You can learn how to make money online from Kevin David, for example, how to save and invest money from Graham Stefan, how to develop high income skills from Dan Locke, how to make YouTube content from Nick Niman or Roberta Blake. If you want to learn how to make thousands of dollars online with affiliated online marketing, check out John Crestani. Also, explore your creative side. That could be learning a new language, writing a book, ads or stories for companies. You should also read more. Rich people read several hours every day. It helps broaden your knowledge, perspective on different topics, and also it helps you synthesize your thoughts. Last, but not least, it can help you become more confident, motivated and more skilled. When investing in yourself, it also means making the right decisions. First of all, if you are in debt, then the best immediate investment you can make is to put as much money as possible towards getting out of it. Create a timeline and budget for getting out of debt, or use budget creation software to keep yourself on track. Also, even if you are in debt, it is important to set aside a portion of your money for savings. Decide how much of your income you want to save as a percentage, then regularly deposit it into a separate account. This is the safest step in case of a major immediate financial need. Besides savings, you should also try to invest your money. This could be savings bond, stocks, estate or commodities. It is important to diversify your portfolio. Also, make sure to educate yourself on whatever you're planning to invest into. The earlier you begin investing, the more time your investments will have to build up. If you invest $1,000 each month starting when you are 20 years old, and continue for 40 years, at 7% interest rate, you will have $2.5 million when you are 60 years old. Also, in smaller proportions, if you are 20 years old now and decide to invest $5,000 in a one-time investment that earns an 8% annual return, you will have accumulated $160,000 by the time you are 65, and that is assuming you make no further investments. Lastly, three more important investments. That is, take care of your body. You should spend time exercising regularly and eating healthier food in order to have a healthy body and a healthy mind. Not only will you look and feel better, but you increase the odds of living a longer life. Also, set aside time and money to travel. This will take you outside your everyday life, and you get to know new food, cultures and languages. Meeting new people will broaden your perspective on life, and you will begin to see travel as an investment, rather than an expense. Lastly, all of these work if you stop procrastinating. This gets us back to the first advice, because part of managing your time well is not putting off until tomorrow what you can do today. Identify the steps that lead up to accomplishing your goals, pick a single one of the steps to start with and remind yourself of the benefits of reaching your goal. As a successful person once said, if you can do it under 2 minutes, don't even think about putting it off. Most goals depend only on a 2-minute step.